Creepiest looking place. There's nothing between us and the train tracks except this empty parking lot. So when the train rolled by, and this was the big train, the metro liner, the California metro liner that ran up and down the coast 4, 5, 6 times a day and through the night. And when it rolled by every day, the whole building would shake. And when the whistle blew, and the whistle faded, it was the coolest sound I've ever heard. I don't mind trains. To this day, anytime. The building itself was just this 4-story chimney, like the shape of one room, straight up. And we lived on the 3rd floor most of the time. There was this weird grating, like 6 foot by 6 foot metal grating that hung about 10 feet in the air, and it was suspended by chains, so it hung down, tilted away from the wall over our heads. And when you turn the switch below it, it would go click, click, click. And then the whole thing would burst into flames. It was someone's great genius idea to put a fireplace, a gas fireplace, 10 feet high on the wall and hang it down over our heads. It's literally the single most unsafe heating system I have ever seen in my life. It was just like this window into the sky, if the sky was on fire. I don't know. It scared the shit out of me, but I love to come home late at night after playing a gig completely drunk and just sit in the dark and turn it on and turn it off and turn it on and turn it off. Endlessly entertaining for a drunk me. And we were kind of in a quandary as to where our lives were going, because we had just been kids a few years before that. Now we're supposed to be adults, but they're sure shit not paying money for people to play music back then. And I didn't quite see how we were going to manage it. When we weren't working, we spent our days rummaging through the used record bins of every store in San Francisco or Berkeley, looking for whatever we were looking for that week. Or we would walk up to the 99-cent store in San Pablo and we'd buy these bashed-in boxes of macaroni and cheese with these dented cans of soup. Or ramen. So much ramen, you cannot believe. I'm sure you know, actually. I think we probably all ate so much fucking ramen. That's gonna kill us more faster than the ink will. But those are just our days. But our nights, man, and I mean every single night, we spent the same way. We went out to play music. We went out to rehearse to play music. Or we went to watch our friends play music. But our nights were swaddled and wrapped in blankets of volume. In these shitty, run-down, awesome clubs in San Francisco. We spent all our nights in these little places, surrounded by sound. And those sounds, those are the sounds that carried us from childhood to adulthood. So every night we went out to make them, the loudest sounds we could possibly make. And we stomped on pedals and we smashed on cymbals and we squealed our keyboards and we picked our microphones and we made the loudest sound we could make every single night of the year. And just hope that someone would notice us. And then you did. And somehow you still do. And that is the kind of thing that gets you from there to here. That's the kind of thing. So there's a girl on a car out in the parking lot. And she says, "Man, come on, come on, come on. Green, gray, whistle.